Late today, we got word that a big project on the south side got a big boost. The Urban Redevelopment Authority has approved $2 million towards some new homes. Channel 11's Trisha Pittman went into the neighborhoods to find out more about this project and what you'll pay to live there.
They say Pittsburgh is one of the most livable cities. So the question is, if you live in Pittsburgh, are you looking for tradition or luxury?
With the recent building trend in high-end loft apartments and condos, Pittsburgh developers are banking on that answer being luxury and lots of it.
It's probably good because Pittsburgh is kind of growing a lot, and I think it should be among the major cities in the United States. So I think that's probably a good sign of that.
This vacant lot at the corner of Hot Metal and Sydney Streets on the south side will soon be the Hot Metal Flats. Granite, hardwood, and walk-in closets are among the standard appointments.
I've been looking around online for different apartments. A lot of them range around $1,500. And being a recent graduate and everything, it's something I can't afford.
Despite the higher rent, there is a market for these lavish living spaces. The Strip District is home to a combo of old and new luxury lofts, such as the Cork Factory, Lot 24, and Three Crossings, which will sit at the site of Pitt, Ohio's current Railroad Street Terminal.
I think that's probably okay. I love the idea of like utilizing old spaces like the Cork Factory, so I think that's pretty cool.
Pretty cool, but maybe not worth the pretty penny for some.
Upper middle class, or whatever you want to call it, you know, they might be attracted to the city, but for the smaller people, it's kind of hard.
Trisha Pittman, Channel 11 News.
Construction on the Hot Metal developments is set to begin in April. The Three Crossings development that Trisha mentioned will be built starting this summer.